should put on some professional headphones or any headphones that you have so you can hear the before and after the noise reduction process. Hey everybody, and welcome back to Premiere Gal on this. Hey everyone, and welcome back to Premiere Gal. Today is a Friday effects tutorial, and in this video, you're going to learn how to make a point of view shot where a person's eyelid opens and closes like they're falling asleep and waking up. So this effect was inspired by Maroon 5's latest music video, Wait, where Adam Levine wakes up in and out of different scenes. So this tutorial will include both the digital and practical approaches to achieving this awesome effect. So before we get into the tutorial, this video uses music from Soundstripe, which is an online music library for filmmakers. It's just $15 per month, and you can get unlimited music tracks for any type of video, such as commercials, tutorials, social media videos, vlogs, and much more. And it makes licensing easy, so you don't have to worry about or wonder whether or not you can use it in your video, because you always can. And I've left a link in the description box as well as a promo code so you can get 10% off Soundstripe. All right, so let's jump in. To mimic the Maroon 5's Wait video's eyelid effect, we decided to set up a rainy day dream scene. So we went outside to film a couple shots of the rain and nature with my Canon M3, and also collected some sounds with my H4N zoom. I had to use an umbrella to protect the zoom from the rain, and Premiere Pub found that pretty interesting. So here in my timeline, you can see the shots that we chose outside, from the rain to the plants, and then we cut inside into the office where Pup is sleeping on the couch and I was editing at my desk and falling asleep while I was waiting for something to render. So we set up the mirrorless Canon M3 to record a wide shot of myself at my desk, and we also used the RemoView K1 4K gimbal camera to record a few other scenic shots around my desk while I was editing in Premiere Pro. So now for the first eyelid closing sequence, when I fall asleep at my desk, we used a practical approach. The effect is completely done through a physical object to achieve this effect. So how did we do it? Well, we actually used the hat that I'm wearing right now, and we placed it over the camera. Since this hat is knitted, it has some holes in it, so we were able to find a hole to screw the tripod plate into the hat and into the bottom of the Canon M3, and we placed it onto the tripod. Then we focused my Canon M3 on my computer monitor to capture the Premiere Pro screen timeline, right? And then we hit record, and then we wrap the hat over top the camera and the lens, of course. And now at the front of the camera, we actually had to use our hands to gently close off the lens to mimic the eye falling asleep. And it took a few takes before we got it just right. And the key here was to open it gently and close it partially a couple of times, and then completely close it off with your fingers until there's no light at all, and then hold it shut for just a few seconds so you have some darkness to work with in post-production. We even tried using red tissue paper, but it didn't look as realistic as the hat. And the reason the hat works so well is because the edges are not completely perfect, because it's fabric and it's red, and most eyelids with light when they're closed have a reddish tint to it. So I included the demo file to the hat inspired eyelid footage and the first beach shot in the dream sequence so you can follow along. So here in Premiere Pro, let's drag the eye closing clip into the timeline. In my case, I transitioned to a beach, so I'm going to move the eyelid closing clip to the layer above and place the ocean footage below. And this is where it gets kind of tricky, because I didn't have the red hat with me at the beach to make it look like the eye was reopening so you could see the dream sequence. So I actually had to use an opacity mask and animate it to mimic the eye opening digitally. So this is where the digital effects come in. So once you see that the eyelid goes completely dark in the timeline, go to effects controls and use the pen tool under opacity to draw a tiny eyelid slit mask over the video in the program panel. I'd recommend zooming out to 25% so it's easier to draw. I then inverted the mask, so when we animate this mask, it'll appear as if the eye opened. So before we animate, I also decreased the mask expansion, so that way there wasn't a chance we would see anything from the ocean video layer below. So then I set the first keyframe to begin animating the mask path. Then I scrubbed ahead about 1 second, and then using the mask path from the program panel, I opened up the mask to be wider by moving the points to look like the eyelid is opening up. This automatically set a new keyframe. So then I wanted it to shut again quickly like a blink. So I copy the first keyframe by hitting Command C on my Mac where it was closed. Then I scrubbed about a half second forward and pasted that keyframe by hitting Command V on my keyboard. Then I wanted it to open a bit more this time, so I scrubbed a fourth of a second later and widened the eyelid again using the points in the program panel. Then again, I scrubbed a bit forward and pasted the first keyframe so it would shut completely. Lastly, the final opening, I scrubbed about a fourth of a second forward and then widened the mask path again until it completely came out of the frame. So right now, if we play it back, it looks too hard on the edges. So it's important to soften the edges of the mask. So let's set a keyframe where the first mask path is, and then move forward a 16th of a second and make the feathering around 115. This makes the edges less hard and a little bit more realistic. And now you may think this looks too red, and I agree, so what I did was actually cut at the point just before the opacity keyframe begins, and then I hit Alt-Option and drag this clip to the layer above to duplicate this entire clip of the eyelid opening. Then go to Effects and search for Tint, and then drag and drop it onto this new clip. And here in Effects Controls, I mapped the white to a dark brown color. And then I made the opacity 95 so we could still see some of the red below. So now it looks more awesome and more realistic. And when an eye opens, it's not just always in focus right away, right? So let's add in some blur. Search for Gaussian blur from the effects, drop it onto the beach clip. And now when the eyelid is open, set a keyframe, then go back to the beginning when the eyelid is closed and increase the amount to about 75 so it's blurred. Now the footage gets less blurry as the eye opens. I also added some third-party plugins to the beach footage. I used some red giant universe effects to make it look more like a dream scene. I applied the universe edge glow and the universe glimmer effect to give it that dreamy feel. And to make the effect have even more pizzazz, I downloaded a couple effects from Production Crate, a lens flare warm transition, and a bokeh warm video clip. Some of the effects from Production Crate are completely free, and others you will need to get a pro membership plan, which is $49 per year for unlimited assets, which is a pretty great deal. So what I did was move the two eyes closing those layers up on the timeline, and then place the lens flare warm transition between them and the beach footage onto layer 2. Then under effects controls, I changed the blend mode to screen to remove the black from the scene. And to make it look brighter, kind of like the brightness you see when you first open your eyes, I keyframed the opacity to make it go from 100% to 0 opacity as the shot panned. Then above the eyelid closed scene, just before it opens, I placed a small snippet of that bokeh clip I got from Production Crate. And from effects controls, I added a screen blend as well to remove the black from it. And then I also reduced the opacity to 22 to make it kind of look like the spots you see when you first close your eyes. And then I added a cross dissolve to make it fade out, and also added some cross dissolves between the eyelid closing on layer 3 and 4 to make the transitions more smooth. So that's all for the Friday effects tutorial. If you like this kind of video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to keep up with all the latest tutorials on Premiere Gal. And now a question for you. What effects have you seen on TV or social media that you would like me to teach? Let me know in a comment below. Thanks again for watching, you all, and I'll see you all next week. Bye. Hey, you guys, it's Gal again here. You guys should click over there to enter my latest giveaway, over $3,000 worth of video prizes. It's awesome. And down there, you can click on my Patreon page to go ahead and leave me a tip to support my effort to provide free video tutorials online. And down there, you can click on the next tutorial to learn something new. Bye.